So in the spirit of our next item, you could say we're going to be walking on sunshine, Matt.
Oh, we could be, yes.
Very
definitely.
Good. What else might we be
desperately trying to think
doing?
Of other songs.
It's not going to be Raining Men.
Oh!
We're going back to the 80s, everybody. Yeah. We're going back to the 80s.
Was it a very cruel summer?
Oh, very good. Get your lycra on, your leggings, your headbands. We're going back to the greatest decade of music ever.
I think
brackets
that's
debatable.
Yeah. Yeah, we are, of course, talking about the 80s this morning, the time that brought us Aha, Wham and countless others.
Some people haven't stopped reliving those memories, and you're going to have a new opportunity very soon because the former Top of the Pops presenter, radio DJ Gary Davis, is going on the road to help us remember. Let's have a look.
Well, just to show you how unpredictable the charts can be, here's a song that went up to number 10, then went down to number 13, then went down to 40, went back up to number 3. This week it's at number 2. And so much so, we're going to play the whole video for the first time on Top of the Pops.
Wake me up before you go, go. Don't leave me hanging on like a yo-yo. Wake me up before you go, go.
Here is one of the funkiest records in the chart this week. It's also the highest climber as well.
Ashes to ashes, funk to funk it. We know Major Tom's a junkie.
It is time to get funky. Top of the Pops, number one television programme again. Thanks very much.
And it will be back next Thursday, live.
We will leave you with Maxi Priest. From Seoul, good night.
Night.
I'm delighted to say that Gary is here with us this morning. Morning, Gary. Even that's just perked us up.
Do you know what? It's perked me up as well, remembering all those fantastic times. Yeah, they were great days.
John's saying, like, the best decade for music. I'm not sure.
Oh, come on.
Come on, Sally.
Come on.
Go on.
Absolutely
go on.
The best decade.
Me.
You never had a decade with so many different genres and groundbreaking genres and genres that are still with us today. So you had the afterbirth of punk, so the birth of electronic music, new romantic music. You had hip-hop didn't exist before the 80s. You had great pop as well, but you had rock with the likes of Queen and Bon Jovi and Def Leppard. And then you had the birth of dance music as we know it today. All in one decade.
Okay,
not to mention
you've convinced
your
me.
Told you.
You've convinced
told you.
Me.
Not to mention your Kylies and your Jasons.
Yes.
Is that the 80s?
Madonna, Whitney,
there we
Prince.
Go.
Come on.
Okay, convinced.
It's right. That range, isn't it? And that's why when I hear your show on Radio 2 on a Saturday night, I can tell you are loving it.
I adore it. It's just like the most joyous 2 hours of the week. It really is.
And there's something at the moment, isn't there, about that nostalgia that we are all really plugged into. And I imagine taking that out on tour is going to be really special.
Do you know what? In December, we tried it out. We did Sounds of the 80s live from Stoke, and we weren't sure how it was going to be. It was in a theatre, you know. Nobody sat down. It was the biggest party for over 2 hours, and we just thought, you know what? We need to take this on the road. Because loads of people said, why don't you bring the show near us? So that's what we're going to do. I mean, Friday, 10th of March, first show, Birmingham Symphony Hall. I can't
wow.
believe it.
Are you allowed to dance in the Symphony Hall?
It's compulsory.
Leg warmers compulsory?
Yeah, absolutely.
Good, good.
Yeah.
So how similar will it be to the actual radio show that we are so familiar with?
Pretty darn similar, actually. Yeah. You know, brilliant 80s music. Some of the features that we do on the show, we have a master mix. So we're going to do a couple of master mixes during the live show. And we have the Sounds of the 80s dancers, who are absolutely fantastic. So if you can imagine iconic 80s movies and videos and the dancers recreating those moves, think Dirty Dancing, think Ghostbusters. And then we've got an 80s icons master mix. So think Prince, think Michael Jackson, Thriller, you know, together with the dance troupe. It looks spectacular, it really is.
I'm imagining them all on the floor doing the oops upside down, you know, doing all of that. I mean, it sounds a bit like a Radio 1 roadshow, basically.
Well, I guess it is, except that it's not by the sea. It's in a, it's in a beautiful theatre. But it's that sort of party vibe, yeah.
Great.
We've seen some great pictures this morning of you presenting Top of the Pops. You know, that was such an era, wasn't it? Tell us about your favourite moments from that time. Because we had the biggest stars who would come onto that programme.
Well, do you know what? you know, when I was a kid, my dream was just to be in the audience. You know, if only I could just be in the audience, because it looks so cool to be there. And then, you know, when I...
oh, my God. I love it.
when I ended up
those moves.
The show,
look at those moves.
I was so nervous initially, but then I just absolutely adored it. And you just got to meet the biggest pop stars in the world.
Jack
and
Ty
you're
there.
Quite smart as well.
Janice, bless her. What? She's such a sweetie, and so sad that we lost her. But we started Top of the Pops and Radio 1 at the same time.
You and Janice?
Janice, yeah. Same day.
Yeah. Oh, wow. Mm. Wow. Lots of our viewers have been getting in touch this morning with their own memories and their own photos. We've got some cracking photos.
You're ready for this.
This one's come from Carolyn. You might recognise who she's with, Gary.
Do you like the hair?
Which one? All of the hair.
There's a lot
great.
Of hair. The hair fills most of the shot,
used to
doesn't it?
It take me hours.
It
hours.
Didn't.
With the hairdryer and the.
I am fascinated by this. So that took work.
Oh, absolutely.
So go on. What was it? Hairdryer, hairspray.
Not so much hairspray, but and curling. Not curling tongs, but you know the little wire brush to.
That's
make
quite a lot of effort.
A lot of effort.
But that kind of hair is quite in now again, isn't it? That whole sort of 80s look is quite trendy, yeah.
That's true, but I'm not going there again.
And some of the clothes, the fashion was a little bit outlandish, but some of it is back again, isn't
it? Yeah, yeah. It'll never go away. I mean, the shoulder pads, I can see, are coming back now.
And when you... if people come and watch the tour, if people come and, like, you know, have an evening, are you expecting people to dress up? Have the big hair. What's the form?
The form is whatever you want. I mean, when we did Stoke, I'd say 70-80% were dressed up, which was quite incredible, you know, from lycra to leg warmers to headbands to Choose Life statement T-shirts.
You've got one of those?
I did have. Or, it's
or
gone.
Maybe a Woo Gary Davis T-shirt.
Woo Gary Davis, OK. Got one of those.
So, yeah, people did come dressed up. But it doesn't matter. If you don't want to dress up, you don't have to. Just come and have a good 80s party.
And what's the demographic of the audience you're expecting? What happened in Stoke? Was it mainly us, basically?
Well, it's really mixed.
Was it?
Yeah, it's really mixed. And it's quite interesting because it's the same with the demographic of my radio show. You know, a lot of young people are really into 80s music.
I guess with TikTok as well. I know my kids, teenagers, but they know a lot of 80s stuff because little snatches of those tunes are there all over social media, aren't
Absolutely.
They?
Yeah. And not just TikTok. I mean, you know, you've got programmes like Stranger Things.
Yes.
You know,
yes.
Kate Bush eventually becoming number one.
Yes.
You know, every Christmas, every single 80s Christmas song is back in
Comes
the top
back.
10.
Yeah. You know. Yeah. There is so much to talk about, isn't there? I don't even know where to start. In terms of the tour, are you going to surprise us with any live guests?
That is the plan.
Oh!
That is the plan.
How much of a surprise? Who can you tell us about?
I can't tell you about anybody because it's going to be a
Kylie
surprise.
Kylie Jason?
It wouldn't be a surprise.
Kylie Jason, come on.
Listen, all I'll say
I'm
is
listening.
That when we did Stoke, we had Holly Johnson from Frankie Goes to Hollywood.
That's great.
And we had Claire Grogan from Altered Images. We will have a surprise guest.
Rick Astley.
I hope. Listen, don't start banding these names around because you're going to get me in trouble. But we will have a surprise guest on the shows with us as well, yeah.
Rick Astley. Matt would be delighted to hear that. Matt's a big Rick Astley fan.
No, please
famously.
Do not put that out there.
is it just me? I'm sure it's not. That whenever your name, Gary Davis, is mentioned, I hear,
it's
Gary
compulsory.
Davis. Does that everywhere you go, people shout, ooh, Gary Davis?
Yeah, I love it.
Do you love it?
Of course I love it. And the thing is, people come up to me and go, ooh, Gary Davis, and they think I'm going to be, like, upset. And yeah, bring it on.
But you still play the jingles, don't you, on
of
Saturday
course.
Nights? Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Absolutely. Be rude not to.
We
and
have
it,
to
it,
celebrate
it's ooh, not woo, right?
Well,
oh.
This is the sort of dilemma. I think it's woo.
OK.
OK, from the original Cane Gang jingle back in the day, from their song Small Town Creed, which was where the Woo Gary Davis jingle came from. I think it's woo, but over the years, people say ooh. So I actually answer to both.
Well, thank you very much indeed for coming in. Ooh and woo, Gary Davis.
Thank
Lovely
you
to
so
meet
much
you.
For having me.
Sometimes people say ooh. I love that.
Everybody under 50 is like, what are they talking about?
going on.
Gary, Sound of the 80s tour, as heard on Radio 2. It's going live, on tour, all over the place. Kicks off, as Gary was saying, in Birmingham in March.
Special guests, plenty of them. I've bandied all sorts of names about this morning. None of them may be true, so I'm not guaranteeing Rick Astley or anyone.
And have you been won over? Is the 80s now the best decade?
Yeah, I think it probably is.
Yeah?
You definitely win.
You've won, Gary. Well done. Well converted. It's 8:59. You're watching BBC Breakfast.